Welcome to our webinar introducing Maple 2023 for industry. I'm Marine Yalichev and I'm working for Maplesoft as a sales engineer. And today I'm very pleased to share with you the new updates and time-saving features that we've included in Maple 2023. So the latest release of Maple was out last month. And so Maple is really our flagship product at Maplesoft, and it's used in many countries, and it's very popular in academic institution. But today this presentation is very focused for our users in industry. So for example, for research and design engineers, or people using this tool for deep analysis for product development. Many of the features in this release were implemented as a direct result of a close relationship and work with our customers. We've had discussion with engineers using Maple, and that really helped us to shape the priorities for our roadmap and to ensure the computational engine underneath Maple stays very powerful, while also giving you a product that is efficient to use and practical for daily engineering design work. So keep in mind, we're here, you can talk to us, and we're always happy to have some feedback and so some discussion with you to make Maple better. Maple is being used across many different engineering disciplines. Here you have a list of few of them to give you some idea and some example of the application that are possible. You have the major branch of electrical, mechanical engineering, civil and structural are covered as well. You can see some example here where Maple is used, for example, in worst case circuit analysis. We've had some webinars on that if you're curious and you want to learn more. Concrete retaining wall design or stability of undersea pipeline, just to name a few. We're also working in thermodynamics, and the building thermophysical property data helps with calculation in thermodynamics. Pressurized air and fuel flows found in aerospace and aircraft design as well. Also, it's important to note that in the last few months, we've noticed a lot of use of Maple in some of the cutting edge innovation that are behind, like environmental science, biotech, pharmaceutical development. Maple is also used a lot for electronics application, and electronics evolves. And we've had a lot of discussion and use case for electric vehicle and also signal processing. We also want to keep supporting people working on quantum level analysis and modeling in physics and chemistry. And I'm going to discuss some of the new features that are supporting this innovation. So Maple has a reputation as the world's most powerful math engine, but we don't stop there. We actually constantly find ways to make the engine underneath perform faster. We want to be able to solve more efficiently and keep up to date with the latest technical advance. Maple users, they want a tool that makes it easy to manage data, to create design report with eye-catching visual like 2D and 3D plots. And we have features to support that. The Maple worksheet, they are converted into protected template and app that make it simple for colleagues in other teams to use. And in this update of Maple 2023, we are proud to deliver a series of improvements also relating to connectivity, connectivity across your existing toolchain using, for example, Python command and RESTful API connection that will allow you to reuse your dataset. We do also have enhancement to several of our specialized packages. So for example, if we talk about signal processing, we have new tools that will let you create, combine, analyze signal in more and more ways, and also on more efficiently. In Maple 2023, we added support for FFT padding, we added a Savitsky-Golay filter, and quantization, and many more things. In the physics package, we included comment for Lagrangian equations and enhancement for greater control over your coordinate system. In the Maple quantum chemistry toolbox, we've added some support as well, for example, for molecular geometry using SMILE formula. And we also added support to let you perform some filtered search across like 40 million journal articles, all of that while staying into Maple. If you want the full rundown of the new features in Maple 2023, you'll find it online on our website. We do have user manual, example of the application that you can follow step by step how to use the new commands and the new enhancement. But for today's presentation, I'm not going to show everything. I'm going to focus on few of the development we've made, and I'm going to discuss this new feature and open that into Maple. So here we go. We are in Maple 2023. So Maple 2023 was released last month, and as I said, we've added lots of new features. But today I would like to discuss these four areas: visualization interface, advanced math and performance, some of the specialized packages, and programming and connectivity. So with Maple, you can solve complex math problems, and I'll show you a couple of features that are related to that. We always want to make sure we provide an efficient and reliable math tool. But it's also important for the user to be comfortable with the tool, with the interface, and to be able to create nice looking documents that will like clearly communicate the results of your analysis. And that's why we're always working on the ease of use, with enhancement to the help system, for example, or the custom palettes that will help save time with like routine tasks. But for the visualization and interface, I wanted to show you the new feature, the color bar for contour and density plot. So here you can see I do have like contour plot, density plot. And now by default, when you create such plot, you will have the color bar here on your right. You will have now an option, color bar, here, and you can set that as false, and so it's gonna remove the color bar from your plot. You can also note that in Maple 2023, we've added new color maps, and more plot type are responsive to global color settings. When you're plotting into Maple, it uses a smart plotting engine, and you will note here that in Maple 2023, we improve the speed and memory usage of plotting. And that's part of the effort that we are continuously making to improve performances. So in Maple 2023, the math engine is way more powerful and faster. For example, units and floating point evaluation will run between 300 times faster. And that's a direct result of us working with the Maple community to make sure that we keep up to date with the algorithm advance for efficient computation. So for example, as well, to show that we try to keep up to date, we've integrated new prefix for units, keta, rona, ronto, queto. So These are new prefixes that have been approved at the end of last year at the General Conference on Weight and Measure, and we've added that to Maple 2023. So here you can see here runograms, and that's fully supported by Maple 2023. So we are working on performances, interface, and visualization, but we are not forgetting our specialized packages. So we've worked on a few of them. We've, for example, expanded the physics package, and now we are supporting more areas such as mechanics, including the Lagrangian, electrodynamics, quantum mechanics, and many more. The thermophysical property data package has also been updated. It's been updated with the IAPWS industrial formulation 1997 for water and steam. The Maple Quantum Chemistry Toolbox now allows you to search scientific literature without even leaving Maple. And you also have a new package, sub-package, quantum computing, that provides exploring algorithm and computation for quantum computer. And you will find also other enhancements through this package. The signal processing package has not been forgotten either, and we do have updates to the convolution command. We support fast Fourier transform and inverse FFT application with padding and truncation. And we also have this new filter, Savitsky-Golay, which is smoothing noisy data and estimating derivative of data when applied to a signal. So this filter works by applying polynomial fitting to a succession of frame and windows containing a fixed number of points. So here in this example, we have X or generated signal, and this signal is being filtered, so we are using the Savitsky-Golay filter. So we filter this signal, and we are using polynomial of the third degree here for the fitting with a frame radius of 25. And here we can have an output as plot and plot this smoother data. So, of course, our focus is Maple and our products, but we know that such tool doesn't exist on its own, and it's part of the tool chain. And it's important to be able to create connection between the different tools that you are using. It saves time and reduces error. Python and API are a topic for us right now, and we're working hard to make sure we implement relevant features. So the Open Maple application provides an interface between Maple and other programs, and now you can use this API for Python. So it's implemented using Python class and Python interface. So the class is letting Python program access the Maple evaluation engine, and the interface allowing the Maple evaluation engine to call Python function. Additionally to that, we are also supporting Python as a language in the code edit region. So this code editor makes it faster for those who are regularly creating code to debug, copy and paste syntax. And it's even more now that it is supporting Python. So if you look at here, the properties, you can see a language here, Python. So that's all I wanted to show you today on Maple, but it's not all we are working on. We are very busy at Maplesoft, and hopefully you've already heard of our other products we are working on. And MapleFlow is our most recent addition to MapleSoft engineering product family. So MapleFlow, it's a combined everyday design calculation tool with a freeform canvas for fluid intuitive fill. And it will allow you all your project design elements to be captured in one place with references, equation, image, and plots. So your design parameter can be used in calculation and turned into professional looking report by using the many word processor type features. Really, MapleFlow is really aimed to be complementary to Maple. It's more designed for users who have more prosaic needs that don't expect to use the programming features of Maple. And that way, we can simply focus on producing design documents that are clean to read and easy to check for errors. With really the aim to be like more productive. And so just wanted to let you know today that the next version of MapleFlow is coming soon. And so if you want to know more about it, please let us know. We can have a discussion. And also if you want to learn more about Maple, or if you want to try the latest version, you can request a free trial on our website. So please feel free to have a look. And now I will take questions.
So just to start here, I do have some questions. So what can you use custom palette for? So it's something I've mentioned quickly in the visualization and interface. So we did add some support for that. And the custom palette really will help to like speed up repeated tasks. So you can, for example, copy a section of a calculation as a task, and then that will be in a palette, and you can then quickly add section like that in specific format. Someone is asking for the new features for graph theory in Maple 2023. So I think I will recommend you to have a look on the website to have really a full view of these new features. Feel free to have a look on the website. Another question here, connectivity. So is Maple able to import data set from other formats like CSV or Excel? So yes, with Maple, you can set up Maple to import data from existing like spreadsheet file, form text file. If you have like library of material of properties or references, so you can create some direct link to write this file. And you can also maybe have a look at the RESTful API. Will Maple be certified for ISO 26262? That's something we've been discussing internally. So we definitely are working on something toward that. Someone is asking about backward compatibility. So for that version of Maple, we are maintaining backward compatibility. But as we said, you do have some like speed difference between each release. So as you're using like the latest release, you will find it like way faster and more powerful. So really recommend for you to use the latest version. That's it for the questions. Feel free to reach out to us. As I said, we're very happy to talk to you and to discuss Maple, MapleFlow, having your feedback and see what we can do to help you. Have a good day and see you soon.